Foley, Oklahoma. Foley is a town in Okfuskey County, Oklahoma, United States. The population was 1,184 at the 2010 census, a gain of 5.2% from 1,126 in 2000. Foley was established in 1903 as a predominantly black pioneer town with persons having Native American ancestry among its citizens. Foley is currently home to barbecue equipment maker, Smoke Aroma Incorporated, and the John Lilly Correctional Center. The Foley Public School District is one of the smallest public school districts in the state of Oklahoma. For the most recent data available, it tied with Sweetwater for the smallest high school with 15 students. For a combined district, K-12, Foley finished first, just ahead of Clarita, 58, and Sweetwater 60, with 51 students. The Foley Historic District is a National Historic Landmark. Currently, Foley hosts the annual Foley Rodeo and Barbecue Festival. This area was settled by Creek freedmen, whose ancestors had been held as slaves of the Creek at the time of Indian removal in the 1830s. After the American Civil War, the United States negotiated new treaties with tribes that allied with the Confederacy. It required them to emancipate their slaves and give them membership in the tribes. Those formerly slaves were called the Creek freedmen. At the time of allotments to individual households under the Dawes Commission, Creek freedmen were registered as such on the Dawes rolls, even if they were of mixed race and also descended directly from Creek ancestors. Creek freedmen set up independent townships, of which Foley was one. The town was established on the land allotted to Abigail Barnett, daughter of James Barnett, a Creek freedman. The coming of the Fort Smith and Western Railroad allowed agricultural land to be more profitably used as a townsite. Property owned by the Barnett family, among other Creek freedmen, was midway between Patton and Castle, and ideal for a station stop. With the approval of the railroad management, Foley, Creek Nation, Indian Territory was incorporated in 1905. It was named for J.B. Foley, an official of the railroad. There were no other Negro towns nearby. It became a center of regional business. During the early part of the 20th century, Foley was one of the wealthiest Negro towns in the U.S. It boasted the first nationally chartered bank owned by blacks, and its own electric company. The town had over 4,000 residents by 1911, and was the home of two colleges, Creek Seminole College, and Methodist Episcopal College. The Masonic Lodge was called the tallest building between Okmulgee and Oklahoma City, when it was built in 1912. Booker T. Washington visited Foley in 1905, and was so impressed that he included Foley in his speeches. Foley's development paralleled that of the railroad. After World War I, a fall in agricultural prices and the bankruptcy of the railroad caused Foley's failure. It went bankrupt in 1939 during the Great Depression. Before World War II, Foley's population had declined to about 700. With the Second Great Migration underway, by 1960 most of the population had left for other urban areas. So far the new Great Migration has not benefited Foley. Foley, Oklahoma A. August 1903, incorporated May 1905. Foley, Creek Nation, IT, established as all-black town on land of Creek Indian freedwoman Abigail Barnett. Organized by T.M. Haynes, first town site manager. Named for J.B. Foley, white roadmaster, who convinced Fort Smith and Western Railroad that blacks could govern themselves. This concept soon boosted population to 4,200. Declared National Historic Landmark District by Congress 5/15/1975. Oklahoma Historical Society. Part of Foley was declared as Foley Historic District and a National Historic Landmark in 1975. The district is roughly bounded by Seward Avenue, Walnut, and Cedar Streets, and the southern city limits of Foley. They have recovered something of the knack for trade that their foreparents in Africa were famous for. Foley, Indian Territory, is the youngest, most enterprising, and in many ways the most interesting of the Negro towns in the U.S. In the 2016 presidential election, the city gave over 78% of the vote to the Democratic Party candidate Hillary Clinton. Foley is located at 35.492813-96.481776. The cemetery is located southwest of the town. According to the United States Census Bureau, the town has a total area of all land. As of the census of 2000, there were 1,126 people, 136 households, and 79 families residing in the town. The population density was 684.6 people per square mile, 265.1 per square kilometer. There were 153 housing units at an average density of 93.0 per square mile, 36.0 per square kilometer. The racial makeup of the town was 35.61% white, 54.71% African American, 4.97% Native American, 0.09% Asian, 1.51% from other races, and 3.11% from two or more races. Hispanic or Latino of any race were 3.11% of the population. There were 136 households, out of which 18.4% had children under the age of 18 living with them, 33.8% were married couples living together, 19.1% had a female householder with no husband present, and 41.9% were non-families. 36.0% of all households were made up of individuals and 19.9% had someone living alone who was 65 years of age or older. The average household size was 2.35 and the average family size was 3.10. In the town, the population was spread out with 7.6% under the age of 18, 9.1% from 18 to 24, 51.0% from 25 to 44, 24.5% from 45 to 64, and 7.7% who were 65 years of age or older. The median age was 39 years. For every 100 females, there were 407.2 males. For every 100 females age 18 and over, there were 490.9 males. The median income for a household in the town was $16,042, and the median income for a family was $27,500. Males had a median income of $21,875 versus $20,625 for females. The per capita income for the town was $9,304. About 25.0% of families and 40.2% of the population were below the poverty line, including 48.5% of those under age 18 and 20.3% of those age 65 or over. Decatur Thomas, C., 1989, Boley, An All-Black Pioneer Town and the Education of Its Children. Dissertation, The University of Akron. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.